Welcome to my teeny tiny talk show.
Welcome to this edition of Teeny Tiny Talks 2 with YouTuber extraordinaire and DIY queen, Lore DIY. Tell me about your outfit today. I feel like you literally are dressed like I was dressed when I was a young pup back in the 90s. I'm like, is Lore DIY my child? I'm like, oh God.
This is what I wear every day. Just like,
I love
top.
It. It's so good.
Just dressed in shorts and a flannel.
Tell me about your hair also. So you're talking about.
Yeah.
Yeah. So is this like dye? Are these extensions or no?
No, this is real.
It's real. It's a real chicness. And also, because I wanted to dye my hair pink, but my peers shamed me into not doing it, so
really?
I'm very jellies.
Oh my gosh, okay, it only lasts like 3 washes.
Really?
Yeah, okay. But like you mix a little bit of dye in conditioner, so it's basically like half deep conditioning treatment that you just leave on your hair for like half an hour, and that's why my hair is so...
It looks so good on your hair, it looks like a mermaid hair.
Thank you, thank you. In my family, YouTube family, it's called the Unicorn Mermaid Hair.
Okay, hold on. You have a YouTube family?
Yeah, all my subscribers. They're YouTube family.
Okay. I was just like, I was like, are you part of like a weird YouTube cult? I love it of other creators.
Also that though too.
Yeah. Quick, the important PSA. I just want to tell you, like, can we get a shot of this please? Of my shoes? Yeah, Scott, get on that. I'm only wearing these flip-flops today because I have a grievous foot injury.
I
don't want you to ever think that I would be a monster who would be wearing flip-flops.
Well, they match your dress, so whatever.
Oh, I know. Like, it's chic. It's chic.
Yeah, but,
like,
they match your dress. Totally fine.
As you are the DIY queen, I need your tips. Like, what would you suggest I could do to like make these the daintiest and the chicest?
I saw the cutest flip-flop DIY. I think they were with like more leather or like suede flip-flops, but they took just like suede string and then turned them into like the wraparound ankle ones.
Should I attach some dainty pink ribbons to these?
Like, you do that!
Lore DIY, you've recently moved to LA. What's the biggest like challenge of being a full-time YouTuber?
I think the biggest thing is separating it from your life because so much of it overlaps that your real life is online because, I mean, we're just real people as well. You know what I mean? Like, we're not faking things. So my boyfriend does daily vlogs, so a lot of people get to kind of like...
Okay, hold up. Was he like a YouTube star before you met or after?
Yeah, he's bigger than I am. He's like 5 million subscribers.
Okay, so you're just... Okay, does that cause strife in your relationship? Are you like... I don't have as many followers. I need to get up there.
No, it's okay because I'm bigger on Instagram and Twitter. He's bigger on YouTube, so it's fine. We're even. We're totally
like,
even.
It's fine. It's fine.
Yeah, it's totally fine.
Okay, also, we need a shameless plug here. What's your boyfriend's YouTube channel?
His is Wasabi Productions, Alex Wasabi.
Okay. Yeah. Is he like cute? Is he chic? Like, we get a pic? Okay, where's the pic gonna appear? Hold on, she's getting a pic for you guys. Oh, okay.
There's us.
Like, we need to zoom in on this chic pic. Like, we're in love. My arms are very meaty. I'm very good looking. Hi. What is your most like treasured DIY possession you've created?
So this is like a little bit cheesy. My grandpa passed down a really cute antique globe and I ended up DIYing it into something a little more modern because it was
a modern globe or like a thing like a
just like a modern globe. Like I did some chalkboard paint and vinyl stickers and stuff like that. It turned out really cute. It's a nice way to like revamp it.
What is like your sort of your great white whale of crafting? Like what is something that you're like a bit intimidated by but you're like determined to do in an upcoming vid?
I would love to do like a full room makeover. Like I would love to take a subscriber's room and totally flip it.
Oh.
I would love to take on something a little bit bigger.
How does it feel to be kind of taking control of your career? You moved to LA, you know, from, we need to look at your secrets for a minute. St. Catharines, from St. Catharines down to LA. How does that make you feel to be really like, I'm on the go, moving to LA, I'm YouTubing full-time. Like, did it make you feel empowered and strong?
I think growing up, I always thought that I would always live in St. Catharines, always be in a small town.
Yeah.
And then even moving to Toronto felt like this really, really huge thing. And then eventually moving to LA, it's like an even bigger thing. So it just feels like a lot of growth and progression.
What do you miss about Toronto when you're living now that you're down in LA?
Oh my gosh, there's so many food places that I miss.
Tell us.
I'm only here
poutine?
For like 4 days. Yeah, so Smokes Poutine.
Yeah.
There's actually a
Smokes. Now, excuse me. You love your allegiance is to Smokes Poutine. Stop this interview immediately.
Are you poutinery?
Just like, I can't wait for like other bacon. Like.
Poutinis. You poutinis. Oh God, like, nope. Smokes all the way.
Like, I'm actually just gonna like, start weeping tears.
Also, Ravi Soups has like the best wrap in the entire world, and I'm literally gonna get it for lunch today because I miss it so much.
Lore DIY constantly is like a lead to the wrong things. Like,
I'm
a soup Nazi girl.
Oh no, I don't like the soups. I like the wraps.
Okay. That was like that was. Oh no, I've heard good things about that. Okay, I was like real worried for a moment that it'd come to blows. What is your best piece of advice for other people who want to become YouTube stars like yourself?
I think it's not focus on the numbers too much. I think a lot of people go into it for the wrong reasons. Where
like what? Like
just like that they want to make money, that they want to be famous. I feel like those are the reasons that are going to push you in the wrong direction. And I don't know, those just lead to like I don't know, just being discouraged if you don't hit those goals. But when you make content that you truly love and that you're passionate about and you're doing it for you, that's when it's like rewarding, when you make a really cool, just like craft or beauty tutorial that you're happy with yourself.
And that's it for this edition of Breenie's Teeny Tiny Talk Show.
Yay!
Don't forget to subscribe to the Teeny Tiny Talk Show.